When it comes to strong female characters in fantasy, there are few as impressive and badass as Jasnah Kholin. In Brandon Sanderson's The Stormlight Archive, Jasnah is famous among the people of Roshar, not just for being a lengthy royalty, but also for her personal brilliance and unorthodox beliefs. One of the facets of her character is that she is a renowned atheist, which in this deeply religious world creates several obstacles for her, including being labelled a heretic. And yet, despite being ostracized, she continues to stand by her convictions. Not once does she compromise her beliefs for the sake of appearances. She stays true to herself, unlike many so-called devout foreign priests who claim to worship the Almighty while turning their backs on their church's teachings in the next minute. It is this sincerity within her that makes Jasnah the honest, noble, and moral person that she is. While she isn't convinced in the existence of the Almighty, at least in the sense of there being an all-powerful, all-knowing God, the basis for her belief is that there simply isn't enough empirical evidence to convince her otherwise. Like a true scholar, she isn't ruled by blind faith, but seeks to come to conclusions on the logical inferences she draws from the evidence before her. As a self-confessed man of faith, Brandon Sanderson has done an excellent job in exploring atheism through a character he has crafted who is both wise and moral, fully capable of appreciating the difference between right and wrong, without following the words of scripture or the threat of divine retribution from some deity. What I personally like about Jasnah is that she is not completely set in her ways either. She keeps an open mind to the many possibilities, and tries to listen to the arguments on all sides, including the Voron Church, if they are presented logically. Also, she doesn't push her beliefs onto others, and is content to keep them to herself, without caring about trying to convert anyone. I do find it rather ironic that the truth of the world lies closer to the dogmatic religious teachings of the church she refused to accept. She presumes that honour and cultivation are immensely powerful spring, when in fact they really are gods, and that the spring are mere fragments of their power given sentience. But we'll forgive Jasnah for this, as to her credit she has no knowledge of Sanderson's wider universe, the Cosmere. There simply isn't enough information yet for her to reach the truth. We are first introduced to Jasnah in The Way of Kings, from the perspective of Shallan Devar, who seeks to be taken on as her ward. Shallan is completely surprised by Jasnah's appearance. She expected a withered, ugly old spinster, but what she found was nothing of the sort. The reality is that she is quite attractive, being described as tall and slender, tan of skin with narrow eyebrows, and thick, deep onyx hair held up in a fine braid. She is reserved, statuesque, and dressed immaculately, and we soon learn that her value lies not solely in her looks, but in her sharp and inquisitive mind. At heart, Jasnah is a determined scholar. Questions drive her. She is confident, determined, and stubborn. But through her study, she shows wisdom beyond her years. This excerpt from one of Jasnah's published writings speaks volumes about her character. It shows us what is a priority for her: freedom of choice. She is not condemning any woman for choosing to be a wife, nor is she saying that the scholarly life is of greater worth. She is arguing a woman should have the right to choose, which could very well be part of the reason that led Jasnah to atheism in the first place. In her eyes, she is now liberated from a belief structure whose rules restrict asking questions, and goes against that gift she cherishes so much, her curiosity. It's very telling of her character that Jasnah chose the path she did. Now, I've seen some people complain about the way Jasnah treats Shallan during their first few interactions together, and how she is completely dismissive of her abilities. But we have to remember that Jasnah was under a lot of stress at the time. She's working on a problem that literally threatens the entire existence of every living being on the planet. She doesn't have the time or patience to take on a ward right now, especially one that excels at drawing, rather than anything Jasnah finds particularly useful, such as history. This is why Jasnah went out of her way to avoid Shallan until the young girl caught up with her, and why she tries to quickly get rid of her. But Shallan persists, and when the girl proves she's willing to take the scholarship and research seriously, Jasnah relents and reconsiders. Again, this shows us that Jasnah accepts when she has made a mistake and is willing to make amends. Once Jasnah realizes Shallan has a genuine love of learning, she feels that it is worth nurturing and takes her on as a ward, which is a clear sign of compassion, despite the cold, strict facade she sometimes puts on for the rest of the world. One of my favorite scenes happens in the first book, when she takes it upon herself to set a trap for four men who have been robbing people in one of Cabram's shady neighborhoods. In the middle of the night, she takes Shallan to a road she knows to be crawling with highwaymen. Four men creep out from the darkness, carrying swords and knives. Jasnah stands firm and waits for one of them to approach her. Suddenly, one swings his knife at her, initiating the attack. Jasnah lifts her hand, touches him, and using her soul-casting powers as an Elsecaller, sets him on fire. She reaches out and brushes against another man, which changes him to quartz. The last two, she vaporizes by shooting twin lightning bolts out from her hands. Shallan is understandably shocked and shaken by these events, but Jasnah simply asks her to treat this as a problem for her research into ethics. Taking a step back to consider the morality of the situation, I think we can safely say that Jasnah was justified in her actions. She researched the crime in the area, realized there were murders happening there, that the thugs would strike again, and that the City Watch would do nothing to prevent it. The fact of the matter is that this particular street had numerous deaths to its name, and there was no sign that the situation would change anytime soon. Added to that, the men were given a chance. They could have chosen not to attack, but they did, and they paid the price for it. They didn't know they would die, any more than their victims knew they'd die for taking the wrong way home. It's an interesting scenario, and while you could say that Jasnah was asking for trouble by having her wealth on full display in that neighborhood, she is right to say that people are allowed to carry their possessions down the street of a city if they want to. What's also interesting about this scene is that we may get our first inkling into Jasnah's past. She clearly harbors a deep resentment towards men like them, and that could possibly be because of something done to her when she was younger. She's a surge binder, and on track to becoming a full-fledged Knight's Radiant, so it goes without saying that she has been broken at some point. But what broke her? We know that Jasnah used to be romantically involved with Amaram, and that their parents wished for a union between them. But given their current spitefulness towards one another, something must have soured the relationship between them. Also, in Oathbringer, Jasnah has a recollection of a memory of her in a room crying, and how nobody seemed to care or remember it. She also later mentions that it was one lesson about how much family can hurt you. In a flashback chapter, Dalinar talks about Jasnah's lunacy to her father Gavilar. We are to believe that Jasnah was 11 years old at the time. So, hypothetically, as a child, Jasnah may have been scouted by an Inkspren, perhaps even Ivory, and felt like she was losing her mind because she was starting to notice strange shadows everywhere and seeing things that weren't there. And then her family, trying to do what was best for her, locked her away in a room full of shadows, where she couldn't escape, surrounded by these nightmarish creatures running rampant. Locking people away into darkness does appear to be a form of treatment for the mentally ill on Roshar. It seems pretty self-explanatory that the people she loved that hurt her might have been her own parents. Unfortunately, since the treatment is very archaic, they probably ended up doing more harm than good. It's possible that Jasnah sought logic and rational thought to dispel what she believed to be hallucinations, and used that in order to escape the treatment. We won't know for sure until Jasnah is featured in a later Stormlight book as a flashback character, but it is still worth theorizing about at this early stage. Now, I'd like to hear your thoughts. Do you like Jasnah's character? What do you think left her broken in the past? Comment down below. And if you enjoyed this video, consider leaving a like and do subscribe for more Stormlight Archive content. Have a great day.